Hello friends, welcome to the 8th tutorial of COMSOL Multiphysics, presented by me, Shishendu Mitra, Research Scholar of Indian Institute of Technology, Guwahati. So today, I'll teach you how to extract data files from COMSOL and how to plot it in some other tools, like you can plot it in Origin, you can plot it in Excel, you can plot in any other tools available for plotting. So here I have already done a simulation of a simple pipe flow. I'll show you the things whichever I did. So I have taken a creeping flow, I solved it for unsteady state, and the inlet conditions I have given as a pressure condition, and the pressure is 2 Pascal, that is the gauge pressure, and at the outlet, at the outlet the pressure is atmospheric pressure, so it is 0 Pascal. So I run it for 0 with a time step of 0.1 up to 1 second, and after simulating I got the velocity profile like this. So from here you can see at the wall we have maintained the no slip boundary condition. So from the velocity profile you can see at wall the velocity is showing 0, blue means 0. And as we go towards the bulk of the pipe, so you can see it is becoming maximum. I can show you. So this is 0.024, go little bit below, so it is increasing, again increasing. You see here from 0.024 it is now 0.08 0.12 0.125 0.127 0.12, now it will again decrease, you see. So this is the parabolic profile. Now without seeing by clicking on each and every point, we can do one more thing. We can take a line on this particular region and we can see what are how the profile is varying along a particular line. So how to do that? So to do so, we go to data set. There is an option under this result section, that is data set. You go there, right click on data set, and then another window will be open, and here you choose cut line 2D. Now here you have to mention the coordinates where you want to take your cut line. Now say I will take a cut line here at x equal to 0.8, y equal to 0 to 0.5. So I put x equal to 8, first point 8, this is the first point, sorry, this is the 0.8, and this one from 0 to 0.5. Now just click on plot, so you will have a cut line. Now this cut line you can change name. I can rename it, say parabolic profile line at x equal to 0.8. click on OK. So the name has been changed. Now after doing this, you go to result, right click on it and take 1D plot group. Once this 1D plot group comes, again you can change the name. I rename it, say velocity profile creeping flow. You can give any name, click on OK. Now the important thing is that you go to parabolic profile. So here is the data set. Now you can see here there is only one option, study 1 solution 1. That means after simulation one data set has been created and you have to choose that data set. Now if I have multiple study in a single file, then in this drop down you will have several study option, and out of the available options you have to choose the data set. Now as there is only one data set, I click on this particular data set. So along this line, the cut line, it will take data from this particular solution. Now I go to 1D plot group. Now here in the data set, you click parabolic profile line x equal to 0.8. So we are linking this to this particular data set. Now choose time, the last time step. I want to plot it for the last time step, that is why I have taken time step last. Now again go to this 1D plot group, right click on it and take a line graph. In this line graph, you take data set from parent. What does it mean? It means it will take the data set whichever is given in this particular velocity profile creeping flow. Now you can see here SPFU expression, that means which particular property, which particular variable you want to plot. Now you can change it. If you click here, we go to creeping flow velocity. Now we are plotting x directional velocity, so we click on this and this is u. Now you click on plot, so this is the profile. Now suppose you want to see how the profile is varying with time, then in order to do so, you go to velocity profile creeping flow, instead of last you choose all and then click on plot. So you can see how the profile is growing with time. So it's an unsteady state flow. As time progresses, the profile develops. This particular thing you can see from here. Now suppose you want to, you are doing some simulation and the result you will be publishing in some journal. So in order to do so, this particular picture or the image, whichever you will get after taking the snapshot of this. Now how to take snapshot? You can click on snapshot, you can choose current, include title, legend, axis. What does it mean? Once these things are checked, it will take this legend, this title and everything as it is in the console. It will be saved. So then I click on OK. Once again, I'll show you. Click here. Now, it was saving in clipboard. Do not save it in clipboard. Choose option file. Here, several options are there. In which format you want to save it? I choose JPEG. And then I go to, I browse in order to choose the location. Suppose I want to save it in desktop only. I give a name, parabolic profile. Then click on save. Then click on OK. Now if I go to desktop, say computer desktop, so there will be something called parabolic profile. So this image I have saved, but the problem is the quality of the image is not too good for publishing paper. Sometimes these things, this kind of pictures, images will not be accepted. So you have to plot it in some other, you have to plot it in some other interface in order to make it, in order to make the resolution good. And to do so, what you have to do, I'll show you. You go to here. For the timing, you choose the option last and click on plot. So this data file, this graph is being generated from some data file. The data file we want to extract. To do so, you go to line graph, click right click on it. There is an option, add plot data to export. You click on it. Once you click on, you will have an option browse. You click there and then choose your location. For the timing, I save it in डेस्कटॉप ओनली, ऐसे पैराबोलिक प्रोफाइल डेटा फाइल। नाउ देर आर सेवरल ऑप्शंस। नाउ फर्स्टली आई सेव इट इन टेक्स्ट ऑप्शन, देन क्लिक ऑन सेव। आफ्टर डूइंग दैट यू हैव टू क्लिक ऑन एक्सपोर्ट टू जेनरेट द डेटा फाइल। वंस आई क्लिक ऑन एक्सपोर्ट द डेटा फाइल विल बी जेनरेटेड। आई कैन चेक इट अगेन। आई गो टू डेस्कटॉप, आई लुक फॉर द डेटा फाइल। So the name is this one, parabolic profile data file. So this data file has been generated. So this data we are plotting there in order to get the velocity profile. So this data file you can plot, from this data file you can plot the graph in some other tool. Okay, one more thing I'll show you. Now again you go to browse. We can save it in some other format, say CSV. CSV mean in Excel format it will be saved. Again click on save and then click on export. Now go to that location, desktop, parabolic profile. Yeah, this is the file. Now you can see here, this is the file that has been generated. Now we can plot it. Just select all the data and then go to insert, XY scatter. Yeah, so you can see this is the profile as we are getting in COMSOL, we are getting in this Excel also. So same data file we have generated. Now I am showing you for how to plot it in Excel, but the same data file you can put in some other plotting tools and have a good quality image. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel.